Hello everybody and welcome back to the last video in our ethical hacking course. Now in this video all I want to say is thank you for sticking to the end with me. I hope you did learn something new. Basically we covered everything from certain basics in Kali Linux, such as using some of the simple commands, basically navigating through the Linux directories, creating files and so on and so on, to later more intermediate stuff such as website penetration testing hacking. We covered SQL injections, basically XSS injections, wireless network hacking, and so on and so on. We also later covered some of the more intermediate to advanced sections such as system hacking with Metasploit framework. We created our own Metasploit framework payloads. We encoded them, we were attacking our OS virtual machine, and then in the more advanced section, we were actually coding our own tools. We managed to code a multifunctioning backdoor, which can actually execute multiple commands, such as screenshot, upload, download files, run a keylogger, basically check for privileges, download files from the internet, and so on and so on. We also coded some of the bruteforcer for the basic authentication, and we also saw how we can actually deliver our payloads, malware, backdoor, viruses, or whatever you want, with the email sending. We can spoof any email with that, and we can send to anyone we want. So, this was about it for this course. In this course, there are over 25 hours of content, so you will actually have something to go back to and actually rewatch some of the videos or redo some of the exercises that you didn't quite get. So you can actually practice, and actually at the end you will be learning everything, and everything that we did in this course will become easy to you. Now this isn't the end. If you want to continue, currently in the process of making are the Python for Ethical Hackers, which will not only cover the same tool that we did right here, which is the advanced backdoor and the bruteforcer, it will cover a bunch of the other tools that you can use for ethical hacking. Now that course is currently in production, it will be available in a few months or weeks. After that, there will be a lot of other courses that will be mostly aimed to some of these specific parts of this Master Ethical Hacking course. So for example, we'll be performing website penetration testing for advanced users, that we'll be doing some of the more advanced attacks there. And for example, system hacking section will be aimed towards Metasploit, where we will actually cover Metasploit from the very beginning to the advanced. Now, we already touched those parts in this course, even though some of the parts were a few hours long, but those are not everything you can do with those tools. So, as I said, in the current process of making is the Python for Ethical Hackers, where we will code our own tools, and after that there will come also some of the more specified ethical hacking parts, such as website penetration testing and so on. So, after that, there will be a lot of other courses, so make sure to stick around and watch them at utina.com. This is where the courses will be uploaded firstly. So I hope you enjoy this course as much as I did making it, and I hope it will actually be a great benefit for you to watch it. I hope you will learn something new, and I hope you will be able to use that for your own needs. Now make sure to stick at the legal side of using all of these tools, since using these tools for bad things, such as actually hacking the accounts you don't have permission to, or attacking websites you don't have permission to attack, can actually get you into a serious trouble. Thank you for sticking around with me, and I hope I see you in the next course, where we will be actually learning Python for Ethical Hackers. Hope I see you there, and take care. Bye.